Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Angie. Today is another video about Zotero, a great tool for managing your references and your sources. I see that some of you are interested in using Zotero Card, which is a plugin in Zotero, so I thought to make a video for you to have a better idea of how to use this plug in to enhance your productivity when taking the notes. So without further ado, let's get started. If you don't know how to install the plugin, I'll quickly show you here. So you go to GitHub and you search for Zotcard. You will see this 018 Zotcard and then you can download it from here. I assume that you have already installed your Zotcard. You just open up a paper and you see this plus item node and plus icon. You press there and you can see there are several card templates ready for you. So they have the abstract cards, quotes card, concept card, persona card, uncommon sense card, skill card, structure card, and asset card. You can take a look at the structure card. The content, you probably want to change the title to abstract, or you can add more about the background, and 1A could be research questions or research gaps or research aims and objectives. So you can structure your paper that way. And for 2, it could be literature review or methodology. For 3, it could be findings and discussions. You can create your own titles, but I find that is quite complex and you don't want to create the same title every time when you are using the Zotcard. So I created a Zotcard that suits my need. So what you do is to go to Tools, Zotcards options and config. So as you can see that the codes are here for the abstract card, codes card and concept cards, and you can amend these codes to suit your needs. Given that I have already created my own, so I'll just click here. And as you can see here, the title has been automatically generated. Determinants of household food waste reduction intention in China, the role of perceived government control, and the year is also automatically generated as well, 2021, journal names, DOI, and also the authors. And with the abstract, you don't have to type it in one by one or copy to Word and then paste it to the Zotcard. What you do is to highlight and then just drag. How easy is that? You can have a read and summarize research background. And with the research problems, you probably want to synthesize and also to summarize in your own words. It's to study relate to your studies. And same with the originality and impact. Some of the papers, it would have originality in the paper. I think some of the journal papers in Emerald Publishings, they have like a specific section for originality. You could also like drag it in for your future references and significance and research gaps. And then the following sections are methodologies, context, where is this study conducted, and data collection methods, how they collect the data. Is it survey or experimental study or interviews or focus groups and scales? Like what are the variables they have been using? For these figures, you could just take a screenshot. Because I'm using a Mac, I'll just use Command Shift and 4. There we go. I'll put it here. Make sure that you don't delete this screenshot if it's recorded on your desktop. Just put it in a folder just in case you lose all the information. Don't ask me why I know that. And then for the following sections, you would have the data analysis, afterwards, that the paper has been using. Is it R or SPSS or some other softwares? What is it? You can also record the mediation and moderation variables in this template as well. Key findings of this study, and you would want to know that as well. Can have academic and also practitioner, industrial implications, which are very important, and you probably want to take a look when you're doing your paper as well. Yeah, so this is the template I created for my own. I found it is very useful and insightful when you want to have a deeper understanding of this paper. Some of the paper you don't have to read word by word, but I do have some of the important papers that I would cite more than once in my upcoming publications. And for those papers, I would definitely record the specific details. And I found that the Zotcard is very useful in taking those notes, annotations as well. And here's the tags, and you can also tag like economy or food reduction. Add like a tag here and also relate to other work one, and then it's recorded. So after you have done this note, you probably want to organize in a large folder so you can record all your important citations. So what you do is you go back to your folder, click here, and then create a new workspace note. You can create the title. I'll just use test and then go. Open. Okay. Go back to this note and then you link test. See? It's right there. You can always delete this one. So what you do is to you have an ID 1. I would suggest to use ID 1. Yeah, there we go. So ID 1. Maybe you want to copy and paste the titles as well, but I think ID 1 works for me. And then if you click on ID 1, it will show that automatically. Okay, so yeah. And it will show you that it's already been linked to the main note, which, perfect. So this is all I want to show you today. If you like this video, please give it a thumb up. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below and I will reply to you as soon as I can. And have a productive day or night. See you in my next video. Thank you.